Let me turn to stem cell research, very controversial issue. The president said he was opposed to federal funding for stem cell research during the campaign. As recently as May, just a few months ago, he wrote this letter: "I oppose federal funding for stem cell research that involves destroying living human embryos." Should the president keep to his word?
Well, I think the president is struggling with this issue. I had a long discussion with the president a couple weeks ago. I think he's trying to find the right answer. He's talked about with medical ethicists, I think, trying to find what it does really happen, what's the right way to approach it, what are the alternatives? Are there adult stem cells, placental blood, placental stem cells that we can use that will do the same job? I think what we don't want is an industry put together to manufacture embryos just so you can take the stem cells out. I think there's other ways. We need to look at the alternatives. I think this is going to be a very measured discussion. And when it comes to the president's decision, I think it'll be a good decision based on a lot of talk and a lot of discussion. And I think if it comes to a debate on the House floor and in the Congress, it'll be also a very, very serious and measured debate as well. I think there's a lot of issues and a lot of moral issues in jeopardy here, and I think it ought to take a very studied debate.
The three other leaders in your leadership, Dick Armey, Tom DeLay, and J.C. Watts, all wrote the president saying no federal funding. What's your view?
Well, I didn't sign that letter. I didn't sign it because I talked to the president. The president said he was working with his Secretary of Health, and Tommy Thompson was trying to get a policy put together. I didn't want to short-circuit that process by writing that letter. I thought that was a fair thing to do.
But what's your view?
I personally am pro-life. I think taking embryos, which is and killing those embryos, certainly doesn't go along with that sanctity of life issue that I think is important.
So no federal funding.
And I don't think that at this point there ought to be federal funding. But I want to look at all the debate before I make solid that decision.
Let me show you an advertisement in the Washington Times the other day from the American Life League, and I'll put it on the screen. The Bush family secret for one-term presidents: a picture of former President Bush, read my lips, no new taxes. A picture of George W. Bush, read my lips, I oppose federal funding for stem cell research embryos. If George W. Bush changes his mind and breaks his campaign promise, will he pay a political price?
You know, what I think is, I think the people of this country want somebody who's serious and will look at issues like this and take all things into consideration. I think the president's done that. When you look at, I don't know who paid for that.
The American Life League, Judy Brown, president.
Okay. So they have a point of view to get across. What I think Americans want is not one point of view or the other, but to have somebody who is serious, who takes all things into consideration. I think that's what the president's doing. And when you look at what the president's done, passing the tax cut, to get education bill through the House of Representatives, to do his faith base and getting that done, to get a budget that's balanced. And you know, the real secret that nobody talks about in the president's budget, we'll have paid down, as of September of this year, $650 billion of public debt. Nobody talks about that, but the president's been able to get that done.
So politically, the president could change his mind if he explained it.
I think what the American people want him to do is to look at this issue, reason it through, and come up with good, solid evidence for the decision he's made. I think that's what they expect of him, and they should expect no less.